Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Dear students, today we study chapter number 3 in mathematics. Indices and the cube. So first, the laws of indices. The laws of indices, let us recall, which are studied in the previous class. Let A and B are the any two rational numbers and M and N are integers. M and N are integers. Then A raised to M into A raised to N is equal to A raised to M plus N. This is a product rule of indices. Second, index is different, base is same. Quotient rule, A raised to M divided by A raised to N is equal to base is common, index is different, so N minus N. Third, base is different, index is same, so A into B raised to M is equal to A raised to M into B raised to M. Separate index for both the rational numbers. Now, any rational number to the power 0, any number to the power 0 is equal to always equal to 1. Then, fifth one, A raised to minus negative index is equal to 1 upon A raised to N. It will become positive. Now double index form, A in the rational, N and N are integers. A raised to N to the power N is equal to, base will remain same, this product of index, M into N. A upon B to the power N is equal to A raised to N upon B raised to N. And last one, A upon B raised to negative index minus N is equal to inverse this B upon A to the power N. So based on these laws, we solve examples. Using the laws of indices with proper number in the boxes. So here, first law, root base is same, A raised to N into B raised to, A raised to M into A raised to N. Index is different, M and N are different, so just you have to add it, product rule, 5 plus 2, 3 raised to 5 plus 2 is equal to, 5 plus 2 is 7. Next is, second one is, quotient rule, 3 raised to 7 divided by 3 raised to 9 is equal to 3 raised to 7 minus 9, that is 7 minus 9 is equal to minus 2. Then double index form 3 raised to 4 raised to the power 5. So base will remain same, product of index 4 5 the, so 3 raised to 4 5 the 20. Under the negative index 5 raised to minus 3 is 1 upon 5 raised to 3. Any number raised to 0 is always equal to 1. 5 raised to 0 is always equal to 1. Index is 1. Base 5, so value will be 5. Now base is different here, A into B raised to N. So here 5 is to 2, into 7 is to 2. 5 upon 7 to the power 3 is 5 is to 3 upon 7 is to 3. And last is, yes, you do the inverse, this will become 7 upon 5 is to 3. Now meaning of the numbers, when index is rational numbers of the form 1 upon n, index is 1 upon n. So in general, nth root of a, nth root of a is expressed as a raised to 1 upon n, or it can be written as root nth root of a. This sign is called as a radical. So now practice set 3.1, question number 1, express the following numbers in the index form. Now whatever numbers are given, let us express in the index form. First is 5th root of 13. So 5th root of 13 can be written as 5th root of 13, which is equal to 13 to the power 1 upon 5. Next, 6th root of 9. 6th root of 9 can be written as
sixth root of 9, which is equal to 9 to the power 1 upon 6.
Then square root of 256.
Square root of 256. Here the number, always hidden number, is 2. It is called a square root of 256, which can be written 256 to the power 1 upon 2.
Cube root of 17.
Cube root of 17. Cube root, order is 3. Here order is 2. So is equal to 17 to the power 1 upon 3.
8th root of 100.
8th root of 100. 8th root of 100 is equal to 100 to the power 1 upon 8.
Index is 1 upon 8. And last is 7th root of 30.
7th root of 30. 7th root of 30. It is equal to 30 to the power 1 upon 7.
Now, question number 2, you have to write in inverse form. Means whatever the index form is there, you should write in the words. Write in nth root of 8. Nth root of 8 given numbers. Now here it is 81 to the power 1 upon 4. So it is 4th root of
81, which can be written as 4th root of 81.
Next is 49 to the power 1 upon 2, means square root of 49, which can be written as square root of 49.
Then 15 to the power 1 upon 5, means it is 5th root of 15, which can be written in words 5th root of 15.
Next, 4th one, 512 to the power 1 upon n, 1 upon 9, n is equal to 9, so it is 9th root of 512, which is equal to, which can be written in the words 9th root of 512. Next is 5th one, 100 to the power 1 upon 19, means it is, order is 19th root
of 100.
And last one, 6, rest to 1 upon 7 is equal to 7th root of 6.
So 7th root of 6.
Now, the meaning of numbers having index in rational form m upon n. Index is m upon n. So generally we can express two meanings of the number a raised to m upon n in two ways we can express. So a raised to m upon n can be written as, now a raised to m power to the power 1 upon n means nth root of nth power of a. And second way you can write the same number a raised to m upon n is equal to a raised to 1 upon n to the power n, means nth power of nth root of a. So in two ways, practice set 3.2, question number 1, complete the following table. So first example is given, 225 to the power 3 upon 2 can be written in the power of 2 as cube of square root of 225. And root of the power, it can be written as square root of cube of 225. Now remaining examples, second one, 45 to the power 4 upon 5 can be written as, it is power of root, so it is 4 power of 5th root of 45. And in root of the power, this can be written as 5th root of 4th power of 45. Now, third one, 81 to the power 6 upon 7 can be written as 6th power, 6th power of 7th root of 81, and in root of the power can be written as 7th root of 6th power of 81. 100 to the power 4 upon 10 can be written as 4th power of 10th root of 100, and in the root of the power can be written as 10th root of 4th power of 100. Last one, fifth one, 21 to the power 3 upon 7 can be written as cube of 7 root of 21, and in the root of the power it can be written as 7th root of cube of 21. Number 2, write the following numbers in the form of rational indices. So first question is square root of 5th power of 121. Square root of 5th power of 121 is equal to 121 to the power 5 upon 2. Second one, cube of 4th root of 324. So 4th root of 324 to the power cube, which is equal to 324 to the power 3 upon 4. Fifth root of square of 264. So fifth root of square of 264, which can be written as in the rational indices form, 264 to the power 2 upon 5. Fourth one, cube root of 3. So cube root of 3 can be written as cube root of 3, and its cube is equal to 3 to the power 3 upon 3. In this manner. Now, cube and cube root. If a number is written 3 times and multiplied, then the product is called cube of that number. Like 1 cube means 1 into 1 into 1, that is 1. 2 cube, 2 into 2 into 2, 8. 3 cube, 3 into 3 into 3, 27, 4 cube 4 into 4 into 4, 64, 5 cube 125, 6 cube 216, 7 cube 343, 8 cube 512, 9 cube 7229 and 10 cube 1000. So everyone should learn this 1 to 10 cubes. 11 cube 133, 1, 12 cube 12 into 12 into 12, 12 into 144 into 12, 1728, 13 into 13 into 13, 2197, 14 into 14 into 14, 27, 44, and 15 cube is equal to 15 into 15 into 15, that is 15, 15 are 225, and 225 into 15 is 375. Now, let us solve practice set 3.3. Find the cube roots of the following numbers. You have to find cube root of 8000. So by factorization method, so prime factors you can find of 8000. Now 0 is the unit place, so we can divide by 4. 2, 4 is 8, 0, 0, 0. Again, 2 2's are 4, 2 2's are 4, 0, 0, 0. Again, 2 1's are 2, 0, 0, 0. Now, 1000, we know that 1000 is, cube root of 1000 is 10. So we can divide this by 10. 10, 1's are 0, 0, 10 hundreds are, 10 tens are, 110 ones are 10, and 10 ones are 10 at last. So this can be written as 2 factors 2 is 3 times, and 10 is 3 times 2 into 2 into 2 into 10 into 10 into 10. So group of that is 2 into 10, which is equal to 20. Therefore, cube root of 8000 is equal to 20. Second example, cube root of 729. So cube root of 729, which is divisible by 9. 9 is the 72, 9 1 is the 9, 9 9 is the 81. And 9 1 is 9. So cube root of 729 is equal to 9 into 9 into 9, group of 9, so is equal to 9. So cube root of 729 is 9. Third one, find cube root of 343. Cube root of 343. So cube root of 343. 343 is divisible by 7. 7 4 is 28. And 7 9 is 63. 7 7 is 49. And 7 1 is 7. So cube root of 343. 7 into 7 into 7. Therefore, cube root of 343 is equal to 7. Now, next example, fourth one, find cube root of minus 512. So, cube root of 512, first factors of 512, divisible by 2, 2 2's are 4, 2 5's are 10, 2 6's are 12, 2 1's are 2, 2 2's are 4, 2 8's are 16, again 2 6's are 4, 2 4's are 8. You know that 64, a cube root of 4, 4 4, 4, 4 1's 4, 16 4's are 64, 4 4's are 16, and 4 1's are 4.
So phi 1 2 can be written as, cube root of phi 1 2 can be written as 2 into 2 into 2 into 4 into 4 into 4. So it is equal to 2 into 4, that is cube root of minus phi 1 2 is minus 8.
Fifth example,
find cube root of 2744. Now 274 is divisible by 2, last digit is 2, so it is divisible by 8 also. So directly we will divide by 2744 divisible by 8. 8 1 is 8, 8 3 is 20, 4 carry 3, 8 4 is 32, carry 2, 8 3 is. Now 343 is the perfect cube root of 7, 7 4 is, and 7 9 is 63, 28, 7 4 is 28, 6 carry, 7 9 is 63, 7 7 is 49, and 7 1 is 7. So cube root of is equal to 8 into 7 into 7 into 7. So cube root of 8 is 2 into 7, which is equal to minus 14. So cube root of minus 2744 is minus 14. Last one, find cube root of 3 2 768. Cube root of 3 2 768. The factors 3 2 768 at unit place is divisible by 2, so 8 is one of the cube factors of it. So 8 4 is 32, 0, 8 9 is 72, so carry, 8 6 is 48. Again, you can divide by 8, 8 5 is 40, 8 1 is 8, 8 2 is 60, again by 8, here 8, 6 is 48, 3 carry, 8 4 is 32. Now 64 is perfect cube root of 4, so 4, 1 is 4, 6 is 24, then 4 is 16, and last 4, 1 is 4. So here group of 3, so this can be written as 8 into 8 into 8 into 4 into 4 into 4. So the cube root 8 into 4 is equal to 32. So cube root of 3 2 7 6 8 is equal to 30. Question number 2, simplify. First one, find cube root of 27 upon 125. Now 27 is the cube root, factors of 27, 3 into 3 into 3 upon cube root of 125 is 5 into 5 into 5. So cube root of 27 upon 125, so is equal to 3 upon 5. Second one, find cube root of 16 upon 54. Now in this example, 16 is not a perfect cube root. So the factors of 16 can be written as 2 into 8, and 54 can be written as 2 into 27. So 2 common, it will get cancelled, which is equal to cube root of 8 can be written as 2 into 2 into 2 upon 27, 3 into 3 into 3, So this is equal to 2 upon 1. If cube root of 729 is equal to 9, then what is the cube root of 0.000729? So the cube root of 0.000729 is equal to, now 0 point, after 0 decimal point there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 digits. So we convert this decimal fraction into the fraction. So cube root of 729 divided by 6 digits, 6 are there, so there will be 6 zeros in the denominator, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now cube root of 729, you know that it is 9, so this can be written 9 into 9 into 9. And here 10 lakhs, that is 6 zeros are there, so it can be written into 100 into 100 into 100, 6 zeros, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So cube root of 9 into 9 into 9 is 9 upon 100, which is equal to, convert into decimal fraction, that is 0.09.